Welcome to the Controversial Russian, and today we're talking about, well, English. So, in my first video, I did a sketchy makeup tutorial, and as you can see, I'm still wearing the makeup. It's not really that visible, I'm still trying. Maybe some of you makeup gurus can recommend something to me to make it easier and more pretty. So today, we're talking about an interesting subject. How did I learn English? Because some of you may think that, oh, she sounds American, she's probably not Russian. Но вы, конечно, сомневаетесь сколько хотите, но я все-таки из России. So let's, jump right into this and talk about how I learned English. So, my dad has went to America when I was 3 years old, and he was in Charleston. And he met some friends there, Paul and Eric, and he was like really good friends with them, and they taught him English. And so he decided, oh my god, America's so great, I gotta teach my daughters English that. I have to teach my daughters English that way so that they can move here and have fun here and just live here. And so he bought this book called Intermediate English Course. And so it's a kind of like, it's the basics. There's like programs here. Like, it says here it's 1976 Langophone Institute Limited, London. So he bought an English book in America. A British book in America, that's interesting. So it has like, the system here is that it has texts, and then after each text there is like notes, forms and patterns, like verb sentences, present continuous, present simple, and how you study it. And then there's like present perfect and past simple, and so on and so on. Some exercises that you can do. And yeah, so he used this book to, well, basically force me to read it. And he would like sit with me, he would tell me everything about this book, he would tell me a lot about like terms, and then he would talk to me, and that's how I got to intermediate. So he started teaching me English when I was 3 years old, and it went like on and on. So first it was the book. In the book there's like it goes like text, then rules, then exercises. I dreaded this book so much because I had to like study and I had to read it, but that was not the worst thing. Then he bought a bunch of magazines from Charleston, about America, and he would make me read them with a dictionary and write down in like a notebook the words that I don't know. And the rule was, the more words that you don't know that you're gonna find in your dictionary and write it down in a notebook, the more you're learning. That means that you're actually doing something. And I, like, one text I would write like 90 words that I don't know, because that's when I started. I was just a little kid. And then I don't have the discs right now with me, but my grandfather, when he was overseas, he bought like 3 nursery rhyme discs with nursery rhyme songs like Twinkle Twinkle Little Star, or This Old Man, or like the Farmer and the Dale, or On Top of Spaghetti. And I had to like learn these songs by heart. I had to sing them and understand what they are. Like, this old man, he played one, he played knick-knack on my thumb, with a knick-knack that he would give a dog a bone. This old man came rolling home, this old man, he played two, and so on. So I had to do that. I had to study these songs, learn how to sing them, and I also had to mimic the sound. I had to mimic the accent, how they're singing, and that's how this accent formed. And then he would like make me watch cartoons in English. Like, he bought these also discs that were like Disney cartoons at first, because like in 2006 you could not upload like videos from the internet. That wasn't a thing yet. So you could not like use torrent to download some cartoons. That happened later. So I used to watch like these cartoons in English and also had to write down words, but that was more difficult because I did not see the word in front of me. There were no subtitles, sadly. So I had to imagine how exactly this word is written, like letter by letter. And that was hard. I usually kind of like missed the point, like I did not understand which letters there were there. Like, it's really hard. Like, I did not know how to write the word through or throughout or like some other words, like I thought, like, or dread. I did not know that there was supposed to be EA. I used to write dread with one E. So, yeah, I had to actually, like, become natural with English and how you write it. And I had to learn that. And so it took me, like, 17 years to get to the level of English that I have now. Now I don't need English subtitles. I'm sorry. I don't need, like, to think a lot. Like, I still have words that I don't know, but I kind of learn without the dictionary what they actually mean from the context. So, it's not really hard to learn English if you dedicate yourself to it. I mean, I think it was hard for my father more than it was for me, because he had to force me to study, and I did not want to, and I would throw temper tantrums. I don't want to learn English. So it was, that was that. And yeah, it was really hard, but I managed to pull through. So I would win a bunch of English contests. Like, me and my sister, we would just, I remember, like, there was a contest where you had to tell a story in English, like, and we learned the Rudyard Kipling fairy tale about the how the elephant got its trunk. And that's interesting also, like, how my dad got me to learn English. There was this website, I don't know if it's still on, but it's called storynori.com, where there was this girl, Natasha, who read text, who was like, "Hello, my name is Natasha, and today I'm going to tell you a Rudyard Kipling story about how the elephant got his trunk." And so we learned this story by heart, and it was like 3 pages of text, and I had to learn it by heart, word by word, and that was just, it was torture for me. I had to study, like, for days, and I had to memorize it. And yeah, now it's kind of easier for me to do that because I am so natural with English that I can kind of like use other words to tell it, but it's easier for me right now to learn it by heart. So it's kind of like it becomes natural over the, like, 17 years that I have studied English. So, yeah. The hardest part for me was actually, like, the terms, like, present perfect or present perfect continuous, or, like, past simple. Do you use past simple or present perfect? I did not know that. I could not figure it out. So, I'm still a little bit, like, I'm not really that good at the terms. Like, I just talk the way lazy, like the lazy talk, like most Americans do, not, no offense. But British English is not for me, like I cannot study it. But I'm gonna show you like the perks of learning English that way. Like, I have friends in America, in Britain, I can do a YouTube channel about it, and I can use my English to spread the word about Russia to Americans and like show that. There are a bunch of stereotypes, like, Russia's not all English, and I'm here to break that stereotype and show you that I can actually learn English, and that it's possible for other Russian kids to learn English. And I want to, like, I don't think you should learn English to go away from Russia. I think you should use your English to make Russia great again. I'm not a Trump follower, but I just use the phrase. You could make Russia great in the eyes of America, in the eyes of like foreign, like other countries, and that's why I created this channel. So yeah, I'm going to show you some parts of English. Like a few 8 months ago, I realized that you can write letters to the Queen of England and Duke and Duchess of Sussex, of Cambridge, Princess of Wales. So I decided to write a few letters and I got response. Here it is, like, this is airmail, and as you can see, it's Miss Maria Moraz and my address. You're not supposed to see it. Oh no, no, you know my address and you're gonna come for me. So this is like, these are the envelopes. And it's also, as you can see, it says Royal Mail. And I have in my possession 4 letters. And the first letter that I got, I had it framed. And as you can see, it has like the sign Buckingham Palace and the text. And all of the letters that I got were answered by the same woman, Claudia Spence. Miss Claudia, if you're watching this video, I'm the girl that annoyed you 4 times by writing the same letter just to different dukes and duchesses. So yes, here as you can see, it's also Claudia Spence, and this is another letter, and it's Clarence House, London. This was to the Duke and Duchess of Cambridge. This one is Princess Royal. It's Buckingham Palace. It's a pretty short letter. And this one is Kensington Palace, the Duke and Duchess of Cambridge, and also Claudia Spence. So I'm gonna do, like, if you want to, I can do a video where I tell you exactly how you can write to the Queen. But this is the perks of learning English. So I can write letters. I have 4 of them, and I'm planning to write even more. And because I want to, like, have this to be proud of. So, yeah. Like, Russians like me can do stuff with English, and that's how I show it. So that's how I learned English. It's easier to learn English when you have a native English speaker to talk to so that he can correct you and tell you what's actually right or wrong. So, yeah, I know, like, basic, like, talkative English, but I'm not sure, like, I cannot read, like, scientific book. Although my favorite book is The Martian by Andy Weir, and if you would like, I can do a Russian review of movies. Type in the comments down below if you would like me to do that, like, do, like, a Russian reviews American movies. I'm actually planning on doing that by reviewing The Red Sparrow, because that is the most interesting hot topic for a Russian to review. I'm gonna do a review on Red Sparrow eventually, because I watched that movie and it was crap. So, yes. So, that's the little story how I learned English. These are 2 videos today, makeup and how I learned English. If you would like to see more tomorrow, I'm gonna do more videos, so make sure you stay tuned and watch my channel. So thank you guys for listening to my rant, unscripted, because the whole point of this video is to show how, not like writing a script, the whole point of my channel is not like writing a script and following it, the point is that I show you like how in real life Russians interact, how they talk, because if I wrote scripts, you'd be like, ah, she's a Kremlin bot and somebody wrote it for her so she could promote Russia. No, I'm gonna talk about politics and my beliefs a little bit later, but I'm gonna be very careful because I don't want Putin to kill me. So yeah, let's just do like this. So thank you for watching my video, and make sure you stay tuned for more, because this is gonna be a very interesting topic. If you want to learn more about Russia, stay tuned. Okay, bye-bye, guys. See ya.